Hey guys, I wanted to do a video on some out-of-the-box settings I made on my Panasonic G85 as soon as I bought it. Now, this is typical when you buy a new camera. There's usually some settings in the menu that you change right away because it applies to 95%, 99% of your photography and you want to have it just kind of set up a certain way out of the box. Now, this is not to imply that this is what you should do. This is just what I did. You might want to make some adjustments here or there, but this is just a general guideline for the kind of photography that I do. And this applies to both stills and video. So, let's get started. Alright, the first thing we're going to do is set the image quality to RAW. Go to the menu, go to this top menu, and then arrow down to quality, and make sure you have this set all the way to RAW. Now this, of course, only applies if you shoot RAW and you edit your shots in software on your computer or on your iPad, and you want the best quality. If you're just getting shots out of the camera, just stick to the highest quality JPEG setting, which is this top setting. But I'll be setting mine to RAW. The next setting I'm going to change is burst rate. There's a big advantage to using M instead of H or SH on this. If you're shooting an M, you get continuous autofocus tracking available, and most importantly, you get live view through the viewfinder when you're taking those continuous shots, meaning it's going to show you the sequence of shots as you're taking it rather than this whole blackout lag behind thing. So you're getting a better quality experience shooting an M even though the burst rate is slightly lower than H. Alright, and down on page 5 of 8 of that menu, you'll see shutter type. Now I like to have this on auto because once the 1 over 4,000th of a second mechanical limit is exceeded by the mechanical shutter, the camera will automatically jump over to the electronic shutter, which is good for 1 over 16,000th of a second, so I like to have that on automatic. I like to have my ISO limit set at 6400 because if I'm going past that, I want that to be a conscious decision on my part because image quality really falls apart at 12,800 and 25,600. So I have my auto ISO capped at 6400. I have my ISO increment set on 1 EV because this allows me to more quickly cycle through them when I'm using the camera. Intermediate ISO values, my style of shooting, I don't really require them, so I have that set to 1 EV instead of 130 EV. I have the extended ISO turned off because all that does is open up ISO 100. Well, what's wrong with ISO 100, you might ask? The problem with ISO 100 is it actually is a software implemented value on this camera that causes you to lose about a stop and a half of dynamic range to get that low value. Now that's not something I want to have to worry about, choosing that by accident, losing dynamic range, so I always have that turned off. Alright, and down on page 7 of 8 of that first menu is a feature called face recognition. Now if you do any kind of vlogging especially, you want to make sure you have this on. And not just on, but go down into memory, and here you can actually assign different faces and name them. And if you register your face, now I haven't confirmed this myself, but I've heard that if you register your face, the camera will do a better job of tracking it than it would just any anonymous face that it picks up. So I went ahead and did that. It does not take long to do. Alright, and moving down to the second main menu on the left side, this is the movie settings menu. I'm going to go ahead and make sure I have my recording format set on MP4. Now what this does is it opens up all of your 4K options, which is the next option down on page 2 of 6, recording quality. I have this set on 4K, 100 megabits per second, 24p. This gives me the best bit rate and the best quality for each frame of video. I typically don't use the in-camera 1080p options because the bit rate is only 28 megabits per second in 60p and 20 megabits per second in 30p. I find it's better to use the 100 megabit signal in 4K and just downsize it in post to get a super high quality 1080p signal. So I have this set on 100 megabits per second, 24p, 4K, all the time. Now I think by default the G85 has the continuous AF turned on in video. I like to have that off because I like to have more control over my video. Now I did set up a custom C2 mode on my mode dial that has continuous AF on and facial autofocus on. I use that for vlogging so it follows my face as I move forward and back. But generally speaking, I want to have that turned off, so that is off. Okay, down here on page 5 of 6, there's a function called mic level adjustment. Now, this is just something I picked up from playing around with it, but I like to have this turned down a little bit instead of at zero. I like to have it on -2 or even -4. Now, this is something you can do right here, is pick a good range that gives you, you know, not too loud, not too quiet, based on the microphone you have hooked up. Right now, with the Rode mic on, I find, generally speaking, I want to stay in the -2 to -4 range, depending on how close I am to the camera. So you want to take that down just a little bit to avoid the possibility of clipping. Alright, now we're on the third main menu. This is the custom menu. And we'll just go ahead and kind of go down here to see what we have. The first thing I'm going to change is the AF sensitivity. I'm going to take this up just one notch to +1. This will just give the camera a little less hesitation in changing the focus setting when you're in continuous AF. I figure that's good to have on, especially when you're doing vlogging and facial tracking. You want to make sure you have your manual focus assist on picture-in-picture so you can not lose the context of the image when you're doing manual focusing. It'll just kind of come up as a inset in your main view. Peaking, you want to make sure you have that on. That gives you just a quick visual of where your focus is when you're in video or stills. Sometimes I like to have histogram on, but usually not. It just takes up real estate on the screen. I like to have the highlight warning turned on, and I like to have the zebra pattern set on zebra 2, which will basically give some patterns at, what is this, at 100%. So when you're right there at clipping highlights, you'll see the zebra patterns. I find that's especially helpful in video or any mode where the exposure is set manually. Now here's a big one. Make sure you have constant preview turned on. This will give you a live view of how your exposure changes affect your image without having to actually take the shot. Now this means when you're composing a video frame, you'll see it actually get darker and brighter as you're changing your manual video settings. And this works in manual still exposure mode as well. Alright, down here on page 8 of 9, you'll see some settings for the eye sensor under this menu. If you hit menu set, I like to make sure the sensitivity is set on low, and I'll get to a big reason why in a few minutes. But it's pretty darn sensitive the way it is, so even setting it on low, for me, it's still pretty high sensitivity. So make sure you have that set on low. Now down here on page 9, you'll see another very important setting. If you use manual focus adapted lenses, maybe a cheaper Metabones adapter that doesn't have any kind of electronic contact. Like, I use this Nikon 25mm f0.95 lens. It does not have any electrical contact, so I have to tell the camera to shoot without lens. This has no detrimental impact when you're shooting with an electronic lens, like all my Panasonic lenses, but this will basically just allow the camera to use the lens and fire the shutter when it cannot detect that there's a lens mounted. So make sure you have shoot without lens turned on. If you have any adapted lenses or manual glass, any lenses without any kind of electronic contact, make sure you have that on. Alright, now we're down here in the setup menu. Go to page 2 of 6 and select beep, and make sure you have this down to the lower of the two settings. This is off, this is high, this is low. The beep on this camera is really loud on high, and even on low it's plenty high. It's as high on low as my other cameras are on high, so I like to have that turned down. I like to have it, but it's way too loud as is. And make sure you have your live view mode set to 60 frames per second. You can turn it down to 30 if you're really trying to watch battery, but there are better ways to prolong battery life, and I'll get to that in a moment. But I like to make sure that's set on 60 so I get a nice smooth view through the viewfinder and through the display. Now here's a big feature on the G85, is this economy mode. If you turn this on, or if you select this menu, you get a whole bunch of settings that help conserve battery life. I have it set to sleep after 2 minutes of idle activity. Sleep mode with Wi-Fi is good to have on so you don't kind of forget that you have it connected, and if it's just sitting there not doing anything. Auto LVF monitor off after 5 minutes, that's good to have if you're doing any kind of extended time-lapse shooting and you're just kind of leaving your camera there and you want it to just to shoot without you having to watch it. That's kind of a common sense thing to have on. And now here's a really cool feature. This is power save LVF shooting. Now, as it says here, if you're using the camera and your eye is away from the viewfinder and you have it set a certain way with the display, and I'll show you how to do that in a moment, after 5 seconds the camera is going to go into a deep sleep mode, and this really saves a lot of battery. Now, like this says, the setting requires a few things to be active. The LVF monitor switch, which is going to be this button up here by default, has to be set to auto, which means the eye sensor is working. And you have to be in your info setting on the back display. So if we hit display and we kind of cycle through our options, you have to be on this display for it to go into sleep mode. And watch here in a few seconds, it did it. And it did that because I was not holding the camera using it. It was not up to my eye. So now let's say I'm just walking around and I say, oh, I need to take a shot. Well, I just wake it up and here it is. And that saves you from having to flip the switch. And to disable that function, all you do is go back to your live view setting. So that's nice. It's kind of conditional like that. You don't have to keep turning this power save feature on and off. It's activated by you using that info display setting. So this comes down to a matter of personal preference, how often you're picking up the camera. If you have it set on 3 seconds, it might be a little bit too quick to go to sleep. 10 seconds might be a little bit too long to realize a lot of the benefits of the power saving. So I have it set on 5 seconds. Alright guys, I hope this was helpful. I just kind of ran through the menus and touched on a few things that I found that are important to set a certain way when I bought the camera. Maybe you're 99% in agreement with me on this. Maybe there are a few things you want done differently, but this is just a guideline. Don't take it too seriously. But anyways, I hope this was helpful again, and thank you for watching.